Today's video is sponsored by Capture One. A few weeks ago, I made a Capture One video designed to help Fujifilm users better understand and use Capture One version 22. Well, the paint isn't even yet dry on that video, and now they have a brand new version, Capture One 23. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. Today we're taking a look at the new Capture One version 23. This video is part of my ongoing series of Capture One training videos with an emphasis on the needs of Fujifilm photographers. Now for today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the major changes and improvements in version 23, which is available right now. As I've said before, Capture One is easier to use than ever, and there's never been a better time to check it out. I will also have for you a discount code that you can use for up to 20% off new annual subscriptions to Capture One version 23. The code is limited to the first 100 people, and it will be included in the description down below this video. And now, let's get into the new features of version 23. First on the list is improved performance. Now, while previous versions of Capture One worked well on both Windows and Mac operating systems, the new version 23 now takes advantage of Windows machines that have multiple GPUs, and it can perform up to 100% faster. The more opportunity that Capture One can use the multiple GPU of the machine to speed up the culling and the time we spend editing our photos, the better. Speaking of which, Capture One now includes significant improvements to both culling and importing photos. Let's take a look at importing. Here we are in the brand new Capture One 23. Let's go ahead and import some photos into a new session. Go ahead and click on Import, and look already, you see we've got new items. First thing right off the bat is that the entire thumbnail display process is much faster. Look at this! Boom! Go all the way down to the bottom and they load instantly. And right during the import process, you can star rate and color tag right on the import screen during the process. For example, before I import, I kind of go through my photos. I look at this one. Hey, that one's pretty good. I like that one. Give it a green. No, I don't like that one. Yeah, that one's pretty good. Give it a green. And then I can simply go ahead and filter by green. Boom. And then import from there. I could also do the same thing with starring. This is a 4-star, 5-star, 4-star, 4-star. And then you can easily filter that as well. I only want to import the 5-star photos. Boom! And of course, you can also filter by camera model, format, date, and so forth. And what's great is during the import process, you can double-click on an image to zoom in and check focus and sharpness. So I'm here and double-click. Boom! You see how fast that was? I'll try another one, double click, boom! And I can go back to my grid by clicking right here. And of course, don't forget your keyboard shortcuts, which can save you a lot of time. Just click on the keyboard shortcuts label right here, and it'll tell you which keyboard shortcuts you can use. Next, while we are still in the import process, there's a new feature called Group Overview. It's located right here, see that? And this allows you to group your images together based on what Capture One calls content similarity. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to go ahead and tick the box Enable Groups. Now have a look at this right here. There's a group of 3, you see that? There's another group of 5 here. There's a group of 6 right here. And notice how these groups are similar images. And you can adjust the similarity using this slider right here. You could drop it all the way down to 2%, in which case it really won't do much. Or you could kick it all the way up to 100%, which may be a little too much. And I have found that the best setting for this is around 75 to 77%. And look at how Capture One was smart enough to group these two images right here, where they're both kind of in the shade, they're roughly the same type of shot, and her face is in shadow, yet it made sure that this image was not part of that, and neither was this one. Obviously, they will group different people in different images together. So say you were shooting weddings and you had different people in those groups, it would put all of those groups together by common group, right? The groomsmen, the bridesmaids, and that sort of thing. You see how this set of images right here is vastly different than this set right here? Or here's a shot right here where she's against a pole, okay? And they're all kind of the same, you see that, right? That's one group. And then I move forward closer and that's in another group. And here's a completely different model in its own separate group. Another thing you can do is click on the viewer right here and that'll show you two columns on the right side. So for example, right here we have a group of three. If I click on this one, boom, it shows the three photos in that group. And I can pick the one that I like the best and tag it for import. Okay, I got enough shots of the model standing kind of far away. I want a shot of her sitting down. I can go and look for the group where she's sitting down, right? Here it is right here. And then I can go ahead and select the best one from that common grouping that I like and tick the box for import. I'm gonna go ahead and import all of these photos for the purposes of this demo. And as you can see during the import, Capture One is importing at the same time it's generating the previews. Okay, so everything I just showed you is in the import screen. And these are all improvements to help you speed up your import process. But what about your catalog or sets of photos that you already have imported? Can you apply these same new features, such as group overview, to already existing photos? Of course you can. Have a look at this. In the main Capture One window now, you've got this brand new Cull icon here. You see it? Just go ahead and click on it and you'll see this window appear. And there you go. You're back to culling with our group overview, filters, and everything else you need to cull through your photos. As well as filter and quickly organize groups of images is a very welcome addition to Capture One. Let's go to the next new feature called Smart Adjustments. This is a brand new tool located in Capture One, and if you don't see it, simply hover your mouse over one of the toolbars, right-click, Add Tool, and look for Smart Adjustments. Now, what the Smart Adjustments tool allows you to do is to take a single image that has the exposure and or the white balance that you want as a reference. Then you can apply that exposure or white balance or both across to hundreds of other images without needing to manually edit them. Check this out. I'm gonna go ahead and edit the white balance in this photo right here just for the purposes of this demo so that you can see it. I'm gonna warm it up a little bit. You see that? Have a look at that. Obviously, this is a lot warmer than I would probably do in real life, but for the purpose of this video to teach this concept, this'll work. So I've made this image a lot warmer. In addition, I'm gonna turn up the exposure just a little bit. There we go. And I'll tick both of these, and I'm gonna go ahead and click Set as Reference. You see that? Boom. Now I've got the color balance and the exposure of this image set as a reference. Now I can go ahead and select additional images to apply it to. I'll go ahead and hit Apply. See that? Now I'm going to look for images taken under slightly different lighting conditions. This time I'll just apply the white balance. See that? Now, a couple of things to know about this tool. First, unlike the typical, you know, traditional copy, paste, different styles that you may be used to in Capture One or in other software, this new feature is designed to match the look across batches of images shot under various lighting conditions. And secondly, it's designed for and it works best with images of people. So, for example, if you have a wedding with people shot in different rooms under different light temperatures, using that color balance reference auto adjustment could be a real time saver. And not only that, but once you've created and adjusted that reference image with the color balance and the exposure that you like, you can save it as something known as a smart style. You can then go in and apply that style, which will automatically set the white balance and or exposure to match the reference. Smart styles also work like regular styles in Capture One in that they can be applied to an entire batch of images. Speaking of styles, the next feature in Capture One 23 is a big one. You can now include layers inside your styles. Previously, when you applied a style in a preset, you didn't quite have the flexibility because it did not include the layered parts of the adjustment at the various opacities. So now what you can do is when you save a style in a preset, it will save any layers that you've created. Now, just to clarify, this will only work with empty and filled masks. The heal, clone, luma range, and gradient layers are currently not yet supported. And once you've done that, bam, you've got your layers included, each with its own predefined opacity. Let me show you more how this works. Let's take this image right here that I'm going to add two layers to. The first is going to be a new filled adjustment layer that I will call contrast. And I'll go to my curves and bump up the contrast. All right, why not? Lots of contrast to that picture. Maybe that's too much. So what I'm gonna do is drop the opacity down to say 50%. Okay, good enough for the demo. Let's go to the next layer. Now for our next layer, I'm gonna call this desaturated. For now, I'll just turn down the saturation. Boom. But I don't want this completely black and white, so I'm gonna bring down the opacity to maybe 25%. Okay, I've got my image here with a couple of layers at different opacities. I'm now gonna save what I've done as a new custom style. I go into my styles and presets, save custom style. Look at this! It pre-selected the two layers that I was working on. I'm gonna go ahead and click save, and I'll call this contrasty and desaturated. And if I look under my custom styles, there it is, you see that? So now, pretend that I close out Capture One completely. And it's a few weeks later, and I've gone to another completely different photo shoot. I have imported my photos back into Capture One in a brand new session, and I want to apply this new style that I created, called Contrasty and Desaturated, to a few of those photos. I can go ahead and select on one of the images, go over to Contrasty and Desaturated, and look at that. You see how adding that style has now added the two layers. And of course, I could go and adjust this further. I can increase the opacity and make it even more desaturated. I could bring up the contrast or bring it down. I could change all of these parameters. This new feature in Capture One 23 gives you so much more flexibility and ability to fine-tune your layers and your styles. This is a great improvement, particularly if you create and sell your own styles and presets. Let's talk about capture time in Capture One. You now have the ability to change the capture time on images. It's located in the menu under Image, Change Capture Time. So for example, if you had the wrong year, you can just quickly change it. You can also quickly and easily apply these capture time changes to multiple images or even all the images in your entire catalog if you want. I can't tell you how helpful this is, especially if you're using multiple cameras and you accidentally, you know, have one of them set to the wrong time zone, or it's set an hour earlier, and so forth. This is one of those features that I was really surprised that they didn't actually implement in the program until now, but it's great to finally see it here. The final feature added to Capture One 23 that I want to talk about has to do with variants. Now, for those of you new to Capture One or don't know this, a variant is a virtual version or copy of your original image. You can have as many of them as you want, and the advantage is that you can have, say, a black and white version or perhaps four different cropped versions, and from a file size perspective, you're basically only dealing with one image stored on your hard drive. Well, now, in Capture One 23, you can actually put your variants of the same image into their own separate album without the other variants tagging along with it. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to go ahead and make a few variants of this image right here. I will right-click the image and select New Variant. And for the first one, I will choose the Acros Film Simulation. Okay, there it is right here. You see that? I'm going to go ahead and make another variant. New Variant. And for this variant, let's go with sepia. Again, just for purposes of this demo. Okay, let's do another one. New variant, let's go for Velvia. Wow, look at what Velvia does to the grass. I love it, I love that film sim. Okay, so now if I go to my library, I'll create a new album. I'll call it Velvia. And I'll drag the Velvia image right into it. Boom. I'll make another album and call it Acros. Let's get that Acros image in there. And as you can see, I have one in Velvia, one in Acros. Now I'm gonna pick another image from a different shoot, right click, new variant. And for this one, let's also set the style to Acros. Let's also turn up our exposure a little bit, do a little curves adjustment. And even though I made other edits to it, like curves adjustment and exposure, I'm still primarily considering this image Acros. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it in the Acros album. Drag it right over, drop it in Acros. Now, if I click on Acros, Boom, I've got my variants in there. These are variants. They're not regular images. They're not really taking up hard drive space. This is a great way to spin up virtual images, experiment with different looks, and then categorize them in your own albums for those looks. Now, besides what I've already gone through today, there are even more improvements and features in the new Capture One 23. The Capture One Live now has additional ways that you can manage the relationship between your collections and live sessions. To learn more about Capture One 23, I will leave a link in the description down below where you can check out the new version. If you've not yet tried out Capture One, this is a great time to jump in and test it out. You can download a free 30-day trial and get access to all of the features that this program has to offer. I will have a discount code that you can use for 20% off. This code is good for the first 100 people, and it will expire on December 31st of this year. I do want to thank Capture One for sponsoring this video and supporting this channel. Well, thank you so much for watching, and I really hope you found the video helpful or at least entertaining. And if you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I will see you again in a new video very soon. Take care.